Hi people, Punky here, welcome back to this channel. In this episode we're doing a review for Tier 5 Russian Heavy Tank, Legend of the Tank, KV-1. So we'll do this review from two main parts, this short in-garage part, then three battles, one mine, one random live game, and one of your best games in this tank. So let's start with appearance of this tank. You know, it is not too big, neither too small. You know, if you compare it, it benchmarked for size on this channel, my red T-34. Yeah, they are roughly same height, you know, and just KV-1 is a little bit wider and longer. So it is perfect size, you know, everything about this tank is just, you know, awesome. Awesome! That's better. Yeah, it looks good also. So what about guns on this tank? Well, you have several guns in selection, you know. You can use even this 57mm, this 4 gun. Many people using 122mm howitzer gun on this tank. But you know, this top gun is something you want to use on this tank. It is not without flaws, you know. It has one small and one big. Alpha damage is 160 for this tank, and what it's packing, you know, it is okay. It is like just okay, you know. More would be OP. Penetration is on a low side, little bit, you know, especially with gold, you know. 120 with standard rounds and 161mm with gold rounds. For HE rounds, 43, it is okay, you know. 12 rounds per minute rate of fire. 0.42 accuracy, okay, for this class, you know, but this is just terrible. 2.9 seconds aiming time. So just because of that, I was forced not only to use gun length drive to increase my aiming time, but also improve the aiming, you know, so you would aim on those tanks faster and so your shots would count. You know, armor on this tank is pretty decent, you know, like we will see now on Tanks GG. Okay, here we have armor of KV-1. On hull, it is easy, 75mm, you know, and it is effective up to 81. And here you have 116, this tiny, you know, edge. But what will happen, usually shells will go here. And if they are a little bit less in caliber, they will bounce despite being just 40mm of armor. So be careful about that. So usually I aiming here. And side is also 75mm. So even angled like this, it is bounce like you can see. And if you're going through tracks, it is impossible to pen this tank. So a turret is 110mm and even more if you shooting in edge, so effectiveness is increasing. And gun mounted is kind of broken. There is big armor and small armor here, so depends, you know, some shots will go in, so I usually aiming here, you know, to have chance to pen this tank. So that is that. Very good for side scraping, except that you are boring to do that because it is very slow, you know, and the traverse speed is even worse. So what about driving of this tank? Well, driving of this tank is a little bit pain in the peep. I didn't even know that, but this tank has terrible traverse speed. When you're turning with this tank, it is like if you're driving a big ship, you know, it will turn very slow. So it needs a very big open field to turn, you know. In town, it will be a little bit grumpy, you know. What you need to do to improve that, and I invested some books even for my driver, is to grind clutch braking, off-road driving, and I don't know if there is any other skill for driver to drive better and smoother and to turn better. That already, you know, clutch braking already improved my turning drastically, but it is still, you know, a little bit on bad sides. How you should use this tank? Well, if you are top tier, sometimes even in tier 6 battles, you need to be in front. You don't have view range in first place. you have solid armor, you know. They will probably use gold on you as soon as they look at you, but you will bounce more rounds than with some other tanks, of course, in same class. So it is pretty good. It is not KV-220-2, you know, but it has better turret than that tank, so it is all rounder, you know. You can go hold down, you can brawl and stuff like that. If you are top tier, don't waste your time, you know, just go there, but make sure your teammates going with you. Don't go alone. You leading pack, you're not going alone, you know, because if you go alone, they will outflank you, they will shoot in your side, which is tough, but not so tough that they cannot pan you. And this tank is prone to catch fire, so both engine and tanks, so you need to be careful about that. Maybe pack automatic fire extinguisher. Yeah, because of that traverse speed and turret speed that are slow, and your gun is not so punchy like on, for example, BDR, you know, it can be very nasty if they outflank you. So, armor wise, you will hold, but you know, eventually they will overrun you. So let's see now that awesome gameplay, and we will talk more during game and to see from first hand what this tank is like. Okay, it is Suzuki map, and we using, like we said, that 85mm standard gun, which is top gun on this tank. With this gun, like we said, you have 120mm of penetration with standard rounds and 161 with gold APCR rounds, 43 with AG rounds. So I shooting there, you know, to scare those a little, you know, light tanks from going in middle to spot. And that is not a bad idea, actually, especially if you have AG rounds to waste. Why? Well, they will not spot you going here, you know, from that hill or from middle, and maybe your light tanks will have better chance to do something. We have one of them, T50, and he is doing passive scouting from middle, which was maybe not bad, or maybe somebody else spotted this. Well, even tank destroyers could spot him, because he is not a very smart cookie, like you will see soon. Okay, that was below average damage of 146, you know, but still I wouldn't kill him with that one shot. You can fire actually more than often AG rounds on even tanks like that. Like you see, I preparing AG round, and I felt he is going, and I decided to be there and to kill him. So we are actually losing kind of for now, but don't worry, that will change soon, because I still have 9 rounds of APCR left, you know, and I will use them to kind of soften this, you know, heavy tanks here. Unfortunately, I was doing constantly below average damage here, so that can be a problem sometimes. Okay, there is Excelsior. I could switch now on standard rounds. I was just in heat of the battle and didn't do it that, and we bounced even that APCR round, and we actually did a nice job with this APCR round. So only now starting struggle, you know, to win this game. So we managed to shut down that DS, but that M4 just staying there, spotted. That was stupid play. He was, I guess, sure that those things cannot pen him, but we can from here, and he's one shot now. Unfortunately, we bounced there. So we'll make sure not to bounce this time. Well, we didn't, but the RNG was somehow on my side, despite not being, you know. So we didn't send around where we wanted, but we still, you know, killed him previously bouncing on similar surface. So unfortunately, I was thinking that was a standard KV-1. In heat of battle, I didn't notice that he is actually in KV-222. So I was shooting, you will see, on full 2 instead of concentrating shooting just in turret. And turret is actually weakest part on that tank, despite not being so bad, you know. But it is weakest part. So whenever you see KV-220-2, you know, just shoot in turret. And here I realize, you know, trading with him maybe will not be smart idea. You see he is orange there, that should be green for like you can see on KV-1 prior his destruction, you know, it was green. So you can pen real KV-1 there, but KV-222 you cannot, because his hull is from KV-3, so very nasty KV-3 tank. So weird combination, KV-3 hull and turret of first KV-1 turret, you know. So now we finish this area, you know, and just few tanks left. Can we do a little bit more damage here? Well, I guess not really. I was hoping to see some artillery pieces here, but let's see. There is artillery. Actually, I preloading HE rounds. That went above average a little bit, and that dude is dead. Now with HE round, I don't know. I somehow catch that destroyed artillery, I guess. And that was 6 kills for me. 2007 HP of damage in this moment of 1100 blocked, you know. So we will see, maybe we did more blind. Okay, so we lost 11,000 credits, 42 shots fired, 30 on target. That is very good accuracy for heavy tank, 9 tanks damage, and we kill 6. All that in 6 minutes of playing. Let's settle on experience. 1,237 stars of experience, 6 kills first in that 2, and 2,297 HP of damage. By far better than anyone else in both teams. So let's see, one tank spotted. We got Top Gun, High Caliber, Steel Wall, Pascucci's Medal, Shellproof, Far Perfect Duelist, Bruiser, Spotter, Hand of God, M Badge, and my first mark of excellence on this tank. I am very close to second one. I had really bad results in maybe 10 last games after I started recording this review, so I played much more than you will see here in last section of review. But yeah, I had few problems with teams, but I am very close to second one. So now let's see one live game. Okie dokie, so now we mounted 122mm howitzer gun on this tank. And we will just show you how unreliable this gun is, because many players playing with this gun, you know, I tried a few games just to see how it is, and it is disaster, you know. Why? Well, aiming time is actually, believe or not, same, 2.9 seconds. But accuracy is worse, 0.52 more. 100 meters versus 0.42, which is much better on standard 80 gun that we saw in previous game. And then damage, you know, this gun you will use to fire HE, of course, but with HE you will do on you know, another tier 5 heavy tank up to 160 HP of damage, which is exactly same damage, you know, that you will do almost constantly with 80 gun firing much faster, if you know what I mean. So you aiming same, but your accuracy is worse, and then you need to punch it in a good place, you know, so you would be able to pan it actually. So that is a trick here. Ooh, they have three artillery in game, and there you go, 113 shooting frontally. With 80 gun I would, you know, be able to hit him sooner and to do more damage. So another thing is, if you want to do those 350 HP of damage, you need to fire hit rounds. And with hit rounds, you know, if you miss once, you will lose. And why I don't see that dude? Something is there. Yes. And you cannot shoot through fenders, you know, and stuff like that. Through trucks. Maybe on some really small tanks, you know. So, like you see, reloading now, preloading that hit run, because my team is already dying and it will be very slow to kill them with this gun, you know, faster. But now, like you can see, I have shot and he's dead, you know. Though MX-13M shot me there, you know. They position artillery very good, you know, and that's just that. Okay, hopefully he is satisfied with that shot. That was very good aim shot. You know, but artillery doesn't giving up. So, wow, three artillery just pounding on me like crazy. I'm dead. Freaking dead. Need to move. Ooh, that is just what I needed, you know. Okay, maybe I shouldn't take that shot, you know, but couldn't wait because I didn't want to miss it, you know. So now Chin wants to go forward, you know. I don't want to go to do that. Wow, that grille is like super precise and all is ready. He knows where am I, you know. So if he can spot something, you know, we will fire at it. If not, we'll go back, you know, because we'll die, you know, going down there. So he's still alive. What the heck? Okay, that was shot from Arty. I shouldn't shoot, you know. I should wait until I stop being. Okay. So that was shot in that anchor. Okay, I think that was a shot. But also I got shot back. Where? I don't know. An artillery hit me also. So you would say, well, why you don't go there, you know, to brawl a little bit? Well, this is spotter tank for some reason still. Ooh, give me that, please. Oh, that was cool. That was cool. Ooh, that was also nice. So, I don't know why he did that, you know. And probably people who drive this tank live for shots like this, you know. But that'll be just a rare occasion, like he said, and you will not do it often. And while you are trying to do that, you know, they will try to hit you with artillery. And that artillery really wanted to kill me, you know. So there is SU-85 there, you know. We see artillery, that would be full damage, but we don't care about damage. You know, we care about winning. But maybe we can take it now. Okay, that is dodgy shot, but we tried, you know. Ooh, he see me. He see me, I see him, that is 4 kill. So, 2 tanks left, I guess I will not take any more damage here in this game. But I just show you how ridiculous this tank is, you know. I could shoot there much faster, removing those obstacles, you know. I could go brawl, you know, because I don't need the reload this big. Okay, in the end, it isn't bad, you know, but this is, trust me, one of my better games with this gun. So, it just happened now that I recorded. So, we'll see later how much experience, because those shots were actually from distance, other tanks were spotting. So, I don't expecting much, you know, experience. But again, what is important, even this will be your good game, you know. Even this will be your good game, very good game. And too often they will just rush you when you are close, you know. They see you using this gun, they will rush you, and while you reload, maybe you will shoot twice, you will be dead, you know. And that is maybe most important point here. Some of blind shots went in, so I am after all first in everything. But this gun is still, in my opinion, something that you should not use. If you want dark guns, you know, Hetzer, Panzer 4H, M4, and of course daddy of them all, KV-2. So that was that. Let's see now your best game in this tank, and I believe it will be just fantastic. Okay, your best game, and surprise surprise, it is actually with this 4, you know, 57 millimeters gun. So we have entire package here, you know. Game with derp howitzer gun, game with top standard gun. And top means also cannon in my language, so it is laugh, you know. And with this 57mm, you know, gun, this Paris map, tier 5 tanks with tier 4 mixes, you know. So, let's see, you know. he doesn't carry much APCR rounds, gold rounds for this gun, you know. This is not much actually. 20 rounds for this gun that is firing so fast, you know, and can miss many and still burns some is not a lot. So let's see how this gun works, you know. We only don't have stock gun, but who needs stock gun on this tank except Soviet Russia. Okay, so if you cannot pen T1, go and pen that new Panzerfaust 1C, you know, tank destroyer, who went probably on wrong corner, you know. They should probably go on B7 position. That's better position for tank destroyers. So okay. He's going down. Maybe to have better view on battlefield. And there is another KV-1. Since he isn't shooting probably dirt gun, you know. He waiting that to aim. Oh, and do you see this crazy gun working here? This is just unbelievable. Still, despite this awesome rate of fire, you know, I would never use this 57mm gun on KV-1, you know. It is kind of, I said already, I wouldn't use even dirt gun, you know, let alone this gun. It is kind of I don't know, you know, like having girlfriend with false tits and lips and butts, you know. So just isn't my cup of cake, you know. Kind of even silly to watch it, you know. This gun kind of looked too tiny. But I must admit, you know, it is not unreasonable, you know. It is very much reasonable to have this gun. Like you can see, you have fantastic rate of fire, damage is accumulating already 2000 HP of damage, you know, and in combination with this solid armor, you know, it can be very good stuff. It is probably, you know, maybe best stuff if you don't mind spending you know, gold in higher tiers, which will happen, a lot of gold, which you don't really need with that standard 80 gun. So that is probably biggest, you know, no factor here for you and for me. I already said, just I don't want to mix this tank with this gun. But fantastic result here, very nicely played, you know. When he saw he has chance to, you know, grab it, to push it, you know, he did it. A little bit of luck also with that first KV-1 that, you know, didn't play best he could, you know, but also he couldn't do much more there against this gun. So you saw three aspects of this tank. If you have, you know, if you have money to spend a lot of gold, and you will need, you know, always gold with this gun, when you meet tier 6 and tier 7 tanks, then go for it, you know, you can do it. Now let's see post game data and let's see what I think about this tank. Should you keep it or not? Okay, so he earned 49,000 credits, 47 shots fired, 42 on targets, very good accuracy. Let's see, 7 tanks damage and he killed 5. All that in 4 minutes, you know. He didn't have time to kill more because everything happened so fast. Set on experience, 1260 stars of experience, 5 kills and 2692 HP of damage. First in all 3. And let's see personal score. He got high caliber, 4 tanks spotted, also 4 perfect fighter, duelist, bruiser and M badge for this tank and this game. So like you can see, you can do it with this gun too, but it will be very expensive and probably cheapest is all in all combination damage, victory and you know, price is actually still that 80 gun, because you will do equally good, you know, in every game and you don't need to fire hit or this APCR runs so fast though I did in that game. So, and in the end that question, should you keep this tank or sell it as soon you unlock next one in line? And my answer is we have 54 battles in this tank, 65% win ratio, nice destruction ratio, we have 1237 maximum experience, 2200 maximum damage and 6 kills in these 54 games. Also, I'm very close to my second mark of excellence, so that is going pretty fast, you know. In my opinion, you know, it is tank that can hold, tank that can carry, and tank that it is fun. Of course, it is not fun like some mediums and light tanks, but for heavy tank it is fun. It is much more fun than BDR egg tank. So yes, for this tank, you know, big yes, if you grind crew and if you take care about a driver and select those mentioned skills and perks first, then you will have one, you know, awesome machine for enjoying. Also, when you are in tier 6 and tier 7, sometimes you will need gold runs, you know. But if you lose some money, you can switch to that howitzer gun when you improve your crew, you know. And then you can run a little bit with that gun, you know, to earn some money. Because HE runs are very, very cheap. So that is that. Big yes again for this tank. Thank you for watching and see ya.